This is a review of vector math. First, the definition of a vector. It's a variable that includes a magnitude and a direction. So like if you're driving your car at 60 miles per hour and you're going east, that would be a vector. Or if you're pushing a box, let's draw that. And you're pushing this box with a vector like this. So this would be the pushing vector, say it has a magnitude of 200 newtons, and you're pushing it at an angle of, say, 35 degrees below the horizontal or below the x-axis, something like that. So there are two ways to write a vector mathematically. You can do them in polar form or Cartesian form. Polar is what we just described, a magnitude and a direction. Cartesian has an x and a y coordinate. So mathematically, vectors can be added or subtracted, or they can be multiplied or divided by a scalar. So when we say scalar, what we mean is a variable that does not include a direction. So that might be like a mass or a time or a temperature. Note that it may be signed. It may be positive or negative. You can have a negative temperature as an example, but there's no direction. There are two basic ways to do vector math:
geometrically and algebraically.
Okay, so let's try an example. In this example, we have an object with two forces on it, and we want to find the net force. So in other words, we want to find F1 plus F2. Let's do this geometrically first. When we do them geometrically, we add them tip to tail. So what that means is, drawing one of the vectors, and it doesn't matter which one you draw first, so there's F1, and then from the tip of that one, we draw the tail of the other one. So we started here, and we finished here. So the net, or the addition of these two vectors, goes from the initial spot to the final spot. Okay, so there's the geometric method. So our results should look like that. Let's do it algebraically with values, with numbers, and see if it comes out to be like that. The first rule, if you're going to do it algebraically, is you must have your vectors in Cartesian form. And right now we don't. We have magnitudes and angles, so we need to convert them. So if we convert them, we should draw an x and y coordinate scheme, put the vector on there so that the tail of the vector is at the origin. So it's 80 newtons and it's 30 degrees above the negative x-axis like that. And we could put down the x and y components of this vector like the sides of a triangle, where this is the x component for F1, and this is the y component for F1. And now we're just solving this triangle with trig. So this would be the hypotenuse times the cosine of 30, because this is the adjacent side, which comes out to be 69.3 newtons. And then this one is 80 newtons times the sine. And that comes out to be 40 newtons. So let's convert the other one. So it has an x component and a y component. So this is F2x, and this is F2y. So this would be, for the x component, would be 30 newtons times the cosine, because it's adjacent, which is 23.0 newtons. And then the y component is 30 newtons times the sine of 40, which is 19.3 newtons. So now we're going to add those two vectors up, which means adding the x components and the y components. So F1, we just determined, is 69.3, but let me scan back up so you can see that this x component here, right there, it's pointing to the left. So it's pointing in the negative x direction. So when we write it down here, we have to remember, it's an easy thing to forget, but you have to remember to make it a negative. And then the y one was pointing in the positive y direction. And now we'll write down F2, and that's going in the negative x direction, and it's going in the negative y direction. So now we're going to get F net by adding up the components. Get the x component by adding those up. We'll get the y component by adding those up. So the x component comes out to be negative 92.3, and the y comes out to be a positive 20.7. So there's the vector. It's in Cartesian form. Very often we need to convert it back to polar form. So let's do that for practice as well. Anytime we do a conversion, we draw a coordinate scheme. We put the vector on the coordinate scheme. So this vector, we know its components first. So here's the x component. Which is 92.3, and the y component, which is 20.7. And then we can draw the hypotenuse, which is the full vector, the full F net. So we can get the magnitude here with the Pythagorean theorem. And we can get the angle here as well. So we can use the inverse tangent of the opposite over near. So that's 12.6 degrees. And notice the angle that we've, or rather the vector we found algebraically, does agree with what we found geometrically. So now let's write down the final result here. Okay, so there's that example. So now let's do multiplying by a scalar. So we want to find half of force vector 1 from the previous example. So when we multiply by a scalar or divide by a scalar, we can do it in polar form or in Cartesian form. So let's do it in both forms. So what we're going to do is multiply the half times the magnitude here, and we're going to leave the angle part alone. So that gives us a result, and then the same angle. So that's how we do it in polar form. So now let's repeat this in Cartesian form. So again, we're multiplying by a half. So the technique now is to multiply each component by the half. In other words, we're distributing that half into this. So that's going to come out to be a half of 69.3, or negative 69.3. So that's negative 34.7, and then a half of 40, which would be 20. So there you go, we've done it in both forms, and if you did the conversion, you'd find that this answer is exactly the same as that answer. Those two are the same. One last thing I'll do is show you how to do this multiplication graphically. Here was our original F1 vector. So half of that would be literally half. So here is one half of F1, which has a magnitude of 40 newtons. So you can see it's the same angle in both cases. So it's 30 degrees for one half of F1, and it's 30 degrees for F1 as well. It's the same angle, just the magnitude changes. All right, well, that's the end of vectors.